consent items, I think there is a recognition or a couple recognitions we'd like to make.
There are. First of all, I don't know, Mr. Haas, if you would like to share about the Distinguished Student Award and Ms. Paul earning that award from IUK.
Yeah, Mrs. Paul, it is an honor to recognize her for the award she received from Indiana University Kokomo. They recognized, was there five of you? Five teachers as distinguished alumni from there. We nominated her from the middle school, and we're so happy that she was recognized by that school.
This just came in Friday?
It was last
Thursday.
Before the agenda.
Yeah, last Thursday evening. Do you mind sharing a little bit and sharing? I was honored to be able to be there with Tammy and her family, and the award is just beautiful. So if you want to share that and share any information that you have or thoughts you would like to.
Indiana University Kokomo decided to recognize their teaching program and their alumni because they felt like they do the same thing at IU, and felt like the program has put out a lot of teachers and wanted to recognize because they have had a lot of firsts with their teaching program there at Indiana University Kokomo, and feel like it's a very strong program, which it has been. So it was a very nice ceremony. Actually, out of the five, three of them graduated the same year that I graduated, so
we don't want to know
that.
Had
a pretty strong class.
That's okay. I was a non-traditional student, so I graduated later, so that's okay. So it was a very nice ceremony that they gave to us. So, and the Indiana Teacher of the Year was there from Logansport, and she's very, very well-spoken and a great representative of our school systems.
As you were for us. Thank you.
Thank you, Tammy. On behalf of the board, thank you very much. We certainly appreciate your service and dedication, students, but this is just something we already knew, but finally you got recognized for. So well done and congratulations.
Thank you.
I think we have the Moore.
We have one other. The Moore family is here. Saturday they had an exciting event happen, and I think that once Mr. Kistler loads up the video, I think that it speaks louder than words, and then just would like for them, I think they wanted a moment maybe to share their thoughts as well. I can tell you when your phone dings on a Saturday afternoon and it's the board president texting you, you get a little bit alarmed, and sometimes they come out to be these great things that happen.
I haven't sent you with bad things on Saturday yet.
Saturday?
Yes.
This was a basketball tournament on Saturday, sixth grade girls.
Kayla, I shot like that in high school. So.
We're not really sure what to say, but to say thank you. I'm probably going to cry. It's been hard to put into words. Kayla came to Rochester in the middle of third grade when they did away with having to, I don't know what you guys would call it, but for us it was did away with having to pay tuition. Being the middle school nurse, her being our youngest, for then, it was because of the need of a babysitter. She could be with me and do what I did, go home with me. We got to spend time together. As she's progressed, she's wanting to do everything that her brothers and sisters who go to Logansport do, and we don't stop her. What all do you do here?
I do basketball and cheer.
And basketball and cheer. So in August, last spring, she was blessed to be picked for the sixth grade team, and she cheered for football and basketball. And then she wanted to try out for basketball. And she made it. And as you can see, she made it. But that day could not have gone, and this year could not have gone on if it had not been for the cheerleading sponsors, Mr. Hawes, making a moment happen for a child that, what'd you want to do?
What?
You wanted to do what? You wanted to score?
Yeah.
And then what did you tell me going home? Who's never scored? No, the other
sister. Yeah, my sister.
So she said, we get in the car and she says, Mom, I scored. Emily's not scored yet. And I said, we can't tell that. So memories do happen here. You guys, I know you guys are the board, but as a parent with a special needs child, the teachers, the coaches, the principals, Oscar's heard me time and time again have tears in my eyes because there were, and not bad, but just because I want her to do all of her abilities. I don't want her disabilities, and that's what happens here. Teachers, coaches see every child's ability. And because they saw that, this allowed to happen. And kudos to Twin Lakes. I did send an email today to them, as did Mrs. Atkinson. But it's amazing, and thank you for the opportunity to allow her to grow and learn and then eventually give. So, and she does work, we work concession stands. So Kayla's a master at the concession stand too. So just thank you.
Thank you for sharing.
Do you have
congratulations, Kayla.
Her only request is a 2-hour delay tomorrow.
Real quickly, and then I'll let Mrs. Paul and the Moores want to leave because you may not want to sit through a whole board meeting. You're certainly welcome to. I wanted to commend Mr. Snyder and Mrs. Weaver for the second grade choir concert. It was a great performance, and they were well behaved, and I think I CC'd you on an email.
Yes, sir.
And then Mr. Bernanke, you received some nice compliments for your support for some students at Riddle as well. So a lot of times we hear about coaches or teachers or negatives in the world. We're obviously doing something right here. So kudos to you all. Congratulations. Thank you. And well done.
Thank you.
So, Tammy, Patty, if you guys want to leave, you can. If you want to stay, you can. We always give you this opportunity. If you want to get out here and not have to sit through this, you're welcome to. Congratulations again, and thank you.
Thanks. I think we're going to go get a milkshake.
Good for you. Shamrock shakes this week, I think. Next, we'll move to consent items. We have a certification of the February 20th, 2017 executive session. Are there any additions, deletions, comments, critiques? If there's not, I'll take a motion if there is.
Consent together.
Oh, we can do all those, can't we? You're right. And then we have the February 20th, 2017 regular board meeting. Any additions, deletions, critiques on that? And last but not least, the minutes of the March 1st, 2017 study session. Any additions, deletions, thoughts on that? Do we have a motion to?
I move to approve the consent items.
Motion was by Steve.
Second.
Second by Tom. All in favor of approving the consent items, raise your right hand. Motion carries 7-0. Financial report.
So tonight we have claims docket number 10,961 to 11,090, totals $866,622.22. We have some payrolls as well that are provided for review to approve. And then we also have the fund reports. Starting with the general fund, for the month of February, we started with $728,061.25. We had $1,035,954.30 worth of receipts. Expenses for the month were $968,644.19, leaving us an ending balance of $795,371.36. And as you'll notice on these, our appropriations have been entered on here. We did receive our final budget order, and appropriations have been updated. So for those of you who aren't familiar or don't know, appropriations are just the permission to spend money. If we get close to exceeding that limit, we would have to file for an additional appropriation hearing and go through those advertising procedures. going on to the debt service fund. It started February with $1,846,497.40. Receipts for the month were $9,522.80. No expenses for the month, so there's an ending balance of $1,856,020.20 for the debt service fund. Cash balance for capital projects fund started at $649,342.31. We had $4,867 worth of receipts. Expenses for the month were $74,426, but leaving us an ending balance of $579,716.98. Transportation fund had a starting balance of $1,090,302.79, $2,240.66 worth of receipts. Expenses for the month were $56,846.31, leaving us an ending balance of $1,035,697.14. Last but not least is our bus replacement fund. Started with $242,169.53. We had receipts of $610.62 and no expenditures since we have not purchased a bus for the year. And our ending balance is $242,780.15. Is there any questions on the funds report as presented?
Is there a motion to approve the financial reports as they were given?
So moved.
Moved by Jenny.
Second.
Stacy beat you to it. Second by Stacy. All in favor of approving the financial report as given, raise your hand. And we actually, let's hold on that till Rick gets back. Rick, we just had a motion by Jenny and a second by Stacy to approve the financial reports as given.
Yes, sir.
If you are in favor, if you are in favor of approving those reports, please raise your right hand. Vote 7-0. Moving on to donations. Multiple donations for FFA, multiple donors, FFA for the Bill McMillan Memorial, $156. Various donations to the FFA from FFA Breakfast, $255. The Northern Indiana Community Foundation, Rochester Community School Corporation Arts Department, $600. Kristen Murphy, for the Arts Department. I'm sorry, Kristen Murphy, a Riddle teacher at Green Filing Cabinet. Various donors for the High School National Honor Society Optimist Club Breakfast, $5. Jennifer Kingery Overmyer Memorial Fund for the RMS Library, $442. Jennifer Kingery Overmyer Memorial Fund for the RHS Library, $442. Crystal King's Good News Club, Columbia Teachers School Supplies. Rochester Telephone Company, RHS Prom Picture Booth, $200. Fritz Hack, Columbia Nurse Needs, $50 Walmart card, and added today, Paula Beeler, Columbia Girls Clothing. Any other additions to the donations?
Not that I'm aware of at this time.
Is there a motion to approve the donations?
So moved.
So moved by Rick.
Second.
Second by Sandy, all in favor? Approved 7-0. And I know we do this every time, but I think it's important we do it every time. I know Tom did, and I'm trying to fall in some big shoes there, but for the RTC viewers out there, thank you so very much to all our, for all our donations and for your donations. They are certainly used and appreciated. So for those of you that donated, thank you.
It's amazing. I know I'm a former English teacher, not math teacher, but as you go down through there, there's probably a little over $2,000 in donations, and that happens month after month after month, and it's just a testimony to the community and their support for the schools.
So thank you. With that, we'll move on to information and analysis, bylaw 100, which is a consent item. What am I not seeing here?
They just have these first readings on those, Brad.
Okay.
It's separated out, bylaw and the first reading of various policies, there. But they're all together. The bylaw 100, there's really nothing special about it except that in the policy, it's just set aside. So just to give a quick rundown on these, the board has been presented with them in a study session. These are what we call our no-brainers, our policies that have been recommended to us to approve based on changes in Indiana code or in case law or other kinds of decision-making or even typographical errors that we need to fix. So, that said, we have in the bylaws changing the definition of a teacher to include school psychologist. in policies 1411, 3211, and 4211. That's adding language for protection of whistleblower and to whom someone can report an alleged mismanagement. 2221 outlines mandatory curriculum. There are just a little bit of change in that, in what the superintendent can and cannot do to change mandatory curriculum. 3120.06 states that for a student teacher to be placed in a supervisory teacher's room, that supervisory teacher must have an evaluation rating of effective or highly effective. 3140 and 3141 separate out resignation and termination. It used to be in one policy, now it's in two separate ones. 3142 incorporates state law that boards can vote to terminate once they have complied with and followed due process, because there were some changes in that process. 3220 has been redefined to match the Indiana Code around teacher and staff evaluations. 5320 changes the wording to allow for parents to select a nurse practitioner or county health nurse to provide immunizations, just reflecting the reality of our medical environment, where it could be not just a physician, but also a different healthcare provider that would provide immunizations. It also adds immunizations for meningitis as recommendations. 7310 gives local control as to how to dispose of textbooks. 8455 is another one with training for coaches. This adds it into a different silo in our policy. This doesn't necessarily change our policy, but adds another one in the programming area. We already had it in a staffing area. 8500 provides that the school provides breakfast for students as required, which we do, but now it's officially in our policy. And 8600, which aligns with Indiana Code that states public schools provide needed transportation for students who live in the district but elect to attend a private or charter school, which is also located in the district. So that is a law that we must follow. So those are all just tonight for first reading. No voting needed on those. And are they up on the, I didn't double check.
Yes, I was just going to ask, Mr. Kiss, are they up on the website?
Yeah.
So if the public
wants to. If anyone in the public wants to take a look and read all of those policies, there you go.
And we do not need to take, that's just the first reading. And then I think we move next to approval of a food finder agreement.
Mrs. Campbell came to me in the fall in regards to our backpack program, where the different schools send home food backpack or backpacks filled with food every Friday afternoon for students and for families. They, her group had collectively come up with a way that we might be able to extend that program, offer it to more students, expedite the process, have fresher food, better food variety for the students and the families. And so it was a great, great proposal. I will be honest, at some point I got busy on something else and Val and Kathy Wilkinson took that on, so I'm gonna let her go a little bit deeper into that. And also wanna thank Ted and Rachel for going over that contract for us and making sure that should the board approve it, that we're on solid ground there as well. But I think it could potentially benefit our families and our community even more so than what we're doing.
Exactly. So what the Food Finders Food Bank of Logansport is, they're pretty much an outreach of what we're currently doing, and on the website are three different documents. One is spells out the guidelines on what we should be following and what we have to follow to be participating in the program and to be eligible for it. The second one goes into a little more criteria where they want to know what kind of facilities do we have to provide for storage of the food, and how do we anticipate getting it out to students and reaching the community and things like that of offering it. The kind of tricky part about it is to be eligible to participate in the Food Finders program, we have to be a 501c3 unit, and unfortunately we're not. We're eligible for other tax sponsorships from there. We're already a tax exempt. We're already tax exempt and just not under a 501c3. So what Food Finders is going to do, they're going to sponsor us. So there's a third agreement in your board packet of the sponsorship agreement and what that guideline looks like from there. So it's ultimate. We Ultimately, Kathy Wilkinson, our food service director, and I met with a representative with Food Finders at one of the buildings. He was ecstatic of what we were able to provide as far as for storage wise, and we, you know, shared with him our goal of launching in the fall of 17 an extension of our backpack program that we're already offering. So we're on solid ground and in agreement with how this is going to enhance what we're already doing.
Will the storage be at each building?
Mm-hmm. A little bit of each.
Any other questions or ideas or thoughts for Val? Jim, anything?
No, I just appreciate Val and Kathy continuing to work on this. Mrs. Campbell for coming to us. Mm-hmm. They will. Mrs. Campbell and her crew will still be an integral part of this and help guide us and monitor that. And they actually launched the program, and we want to make sure that they continue to have a vested interest in this. It's just a way to make sure we're providing as much as we can for those students who really do need it. So I'm hoping to get this started in the fall for our families.
Is there a motion to approve the approval for the Food Finder agreement?
So moved.
Moving first motion by Sandy.
Second.
Second by Tom. All in favor of the approval of the Food Finder agreement, raise your right hand. Motion carries 7-0.
And to be clear too, this is at no additional cost to the school.
Correct.
And the people that continue to want to make tax deductible donations can do so through the Kids Food Bridge program.
Correct.
And thank you, like you mentioned, Jana, I appreciate Kathy and Val taking that on. And Elisa Campbell, this was a brainchild of her many, many years ago, and it was the result of her working hard to help fill a need and then seeing how she could bring it to a bigger audience, so I think, Elisa.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely.
We'll move to the faculty and staff focus with the personnel report. Reassignment, Kristen Horn from High School Guidance Secretary to High School Extracurricular Activities Treasurer. Priscilla Krill from Substitute Bus Driver to Regular Route Bus Driver. Sue Cash from Middle School Media Coordinator to High School Guidance Secretary. Under Family Medical Leave, Deb Miller, Riddle Special Ed, January 27th, 2017, using intermittent days. Sports resignations, Mr. Rex Reinholdt, the head boys basketball coach, effective immediately. Allison Reinholdt, Columbia K-12 basketball coordinator, effective March 17th, 2017. And there are some spring coaching recommendations from Mr. March. For high school track, all these are volunteer assistants. Jared Richardson, John Walkman, Alicia Walkman, and Jason Kaiser. For middle school track, the RMS head coach will be Alan Sager, RMS assistant coach Leah Hinderleiter, and RMS assistant coach Misty Kripe. And then baseball, JV baseball coach Tony Stasiak. And you can see the difference in the places they've served in the past and the coaching staff. Any comments, concerns on the approval of the personnel report? In that case, is there a motion to approve the personnel report?
I move that we approve this personnel report.
Motion by Steve.
Second.
Second by Jenny. All in favor of approving the personnel report as written, raise your right hand. Motion carries 7-0.
Was there a late one submitted? I think we have a gentleman. It's Mr. McCarthy's.
You didn't. You took it back with you, the copy.
Oh, I have the copy.
Yeah, I didn't.
Would you like to share your request for retirement?
Oh, okay.
I wasn't going to let the cat out of the bag. So.
Susie, my wife, has retired 3 years ago, and we get to go on these camping trips from time to time, and when Sunday rolls around and it's time to go back, I kind of feel like, yeah, I'd like to keep camping. And when we get back from our camping trips, we're not yelling at each other, so looks like this might work out. So planning on retiring then at the end of June.
Do we have to accept that?
I just was thinking that.
Maybe he could start on Tuesday.
We could say no, we don't. But.
Sorry.
Well, I'm glad we have at least a little bit more time with you, and we'll have several chances to thank you for your service. We can start early and do it several times. Thank you for all you have done for Rochester Community School Corporation over the years, from teacher to tech to everything you've done. Thank you so very much. And I'm like Sandy. I don't know if I want to approve that retirement.
But I knew it was for camping.
And I would be remiss if I didn't mention he was also a yearbook sponsor for years, and that in and of itself is a huge endeavor. So.
Well, even though he's only like 32, I don't remember back that far when he's done. So.
I've had a really good time here in this new position working with students in grades K through 6. Most of my work was in middle school and high school, so those younger kids are just a blast, and the teachers we have that invite me into their classrooms are just, they're making a great time for me. So now my office has got second grade artwork decorated. It's been a lot of fun to try another age group.
Well, congratulations for you, Mac, and well deserved.
Thank you.
We have another. I hate to go jump right to the next one because I'm still.
We'll have to make a motion to approve that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Or not.
Do you want us to wait? Do you want to make sure this is what you want to do?
Wait till next month.
Yeah, we can always wait till next month. But.
I say go for it.
It's your retirement, so. Well, in that case, Dan has offered his retirement at the end of June, June 30th, 2017.
Right.
So if there is a motion to approve Dan's retirement. First motion's by Rick. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Jenny will second. All those in favor of approving Dan McCarthy's retirement on June 30, 2017, please, 2017, please raise your right hand. 7-0.
8-0.
You know what? We added 8-0 even though he's not an official board. Congratulations again. We also have a JAG proposal here for an overnight trip.
You do. In front of you should be copies of an overnight field trip, and I apologize for the timing on this, but it was something that could not have been planned ahead. There was a regional meeting of our JAG students. They go through a competition that was held at South Bend, and I was honored to be one of the judges there. And our JAG students performed very, very well there, and we have a handful of students who will be moving on to Indianapolis for the state competition. It's a wonderful opportunity for them to meet people, to present their plans, their thoughts. There are different categories that the students represent our school in. There's opportunity for scholarship once they graduate that they can take that with them. It is scheduled for this weekend, and again, I know it is short notice for an overnight field trip, but based on the competition and the results, it was something that we could not have planned much more in advance for. So. I would respectfully recommend that we approve this so those students can represent Rochester schools and themselves this weekend at the state competition.
Is there a motion to approve the overnight trip for JAG?
I make a motion.
Stacy made the motion, second by Sandy. All in favor of approving the overnight JAG trip, raise your right hand, please. Motion carries 7-0. Any other thing for personnel report that I missed? If that, we'll move on to superintendent's business.
Well, just as we just recognized the JAG students, and we'll bring you very specific results, Mrs. Snyder shared that at the FCCLA convention that you approved also for the overnight, our students did very well there as well. Kinley Lingenfelder was a gold national qualifier in fashion design. Ariana Jacobs and Mia Ferris were also gold national qualifiers for the life event planning. And then we had a handful of students who received bronze awards, Alyssa Bell, for an advocacy project that she did. So congratulations to Mrs. Snyder and to those students and the opportunity. Thank you for that opportunity to allow those students to attend that state conference. I think it's a great endeavor for our students, and they performed very well there as well. If we could take just a moment, beginning with Mr. Snyder, if you would like to share just a little bit about your enrichment activities over spring break, and if there's still room available in regards to intercession for remediation, or parents who may want to continue that routine for students.
We've got intercession the second week, the first 4 days of that second week, and we do still have room for that. Notifications will be going out here. We just got our bus routes. So parents will be getting notified here before the end of the week exactly about the transportation and all that, but that's still available. And then we've also got planned a enrichment activity. Potawatomi Zoo is gonna bring out, instead of going to the Potawatomi Zoo, they're actually gonna bring animals to Columbia. And that's on March 28th at noon. and we still have availability for that. It costs $4, and that money just to cover the expenses for that. And we've got lunch prior to that, so if anybody wants to come eat and then sit in on that presentation, they're going to, like I said, bring some animals and talk to the kids about them, let the kids, you know, have an opportunity to see them, ask questions, and do that. So that's what we've got planned right now.
Thank you. Mr. Bernanke?
Yep. For Riddle's enrichment program, we're going to do, Mr. Goss is going to take students on a bike ride down the Nickel Plate Trail. He's done that in the past. I want to say that's on March 28th as well. There's room still available for that. The cost is $2. I think that's going to cover the cost of maybe a hot dog and drink or something like that. Mr. Goss just requests that, make sure you have appropriate weather apparel and also a steady bike, and to know that they'll be traveling far down that trail. And any parent volunteers that want to come, that makes the trip a lot easier with the amount of kids, some faster, some slower. So the more the merrier. And we thank Mr. Goss for taking that on, as he normally does with the students on our enrichment programs, but also with getting kids excited about biking. So
thank you.
And with the intercession will be in Columbia for the elementary school. Mm-hmm. So Riddle intercession will be in our building as well. So that's something I know that gets kind of confusing, because we switch buildings every spring and fall. So we'll be at Columbia for both schools.
Mr. Haas?
On the 28th, Ms. Cox and Mr. Roberts are going to take a group of kids to the Sky Zone in Fort Wayne. And they're leaving at 11, should be back by 3 or 3:30. That allows the kids who are attending intercession to also participate in that activity. And we will have free lunch for the community every day during intercession that second week, I believe, at both buildings, right? Yours and mine, Jason?
Yep. Breakfast, Dan.
Breakfast
and lunch.
Yeah, their breakfast and lunches are served during that time.
I'll say that again, please, because I was asking you and they were talking.
Sure.
Something
breakfast, breakfast and lunch will be served during that intercession time period for students, so families need not worry about that before the remediation programs and immediately following that. And then I know Mr. Strasser was not able to be here this evening, but the high school has planned a college visit to IPFW for those students who may not normally get the opportunity to take a college visit. They're going to tour that campus and answer questions in regards to college admittance, the planning, FAFSA, those types of things for those high school students. So, and I know that they have contacted parents in regards to any remediation that may need there. That's very specialized in regards to credit recovery and those things, so those parents have been notified. And then finally, lots of talk going on, but the team is on board, and this fall we are, Mr. Kistler is looking at me already, we are working collectively to bring online registration to families and to the communities. It's been a bit of a push from the community, and this year with the different construction projects, those things going on, it's just time to make that great leap. And so we're working diligently with the head secretaries and with the technology department and the different transportation departments, food departments. So we ask the community to stay tuned. We'll get you some information as soon as we feel we have a viable program ready to roll out for them to begin to engage in, and we'll have that window open up for a couple weeks for them. We'll have places within the district, if you don't have computer access, if you need help with that, if you have questions around that, we will have those accessible to the community. Val and Scott are working on getting a computer there at central office so that we can help from that perspective as well, not only during this time period, but with free and reduced lunch or registration, transportation right there in our central office to alleviate some of the pressures on the main building's office space as well. So working on those collectively, and we'll see.
You're going to reduce the amount and number of forms, right, Mr. Kistler? Well, Mrs. Weaver, we've all previously registered online and gone in and done 13 more forms, and she's getting on me about it, so I'm holding you responsible.
You got to look straight ahead.
I'm just teasing. I know you guys do the absolute best you can. I really do.
We're working on that.
Will it be paying online or just mail check later?
No, we'll be able to pay online as well. Knock on wood.
It's working.
We're bringing it together.
Is there some way that that it would be feasible or to work with the library and their computers?
With the public library? We can reach out to them, absolutely we can.
I mean, they've got a
bunch in there. We can make a phone call there and see. I don't want to speak for them, but they've most certainly joined us in other endeavors, so. That's all I have.
That's all you have. Any comments from the board? Jenny? Sandy?
No, I did call this afternoon, though, to see if we were letting the little children out, then why the old people haven't come out tonight.
Well, unless, and for us, I think it's a little different, and that's a great question. But unless the roads are closed or under some kind of, through the county or EMA, then I know you do. I know, I went to work this morning at 6:30 and I wanted a weather delay too, but it didn't work.
I did see one person, Barron, posted on Facebook that about releasing at 1:30, and one person responded, are the roads really that bad? And I'm thinking, okay, country roads, don't look at the city streets, you know.
Well, it's a viable question.
Today was a tough, I had Skeeter in my office and Bill Hamill, who's been helping with transportation, and we've been contacting the highway department. And as soon as we made that call and had it ready to roll out, sure enough, the sun came out and there we were. But trying to err on the side of safety for the students, and at the time, felt that was the best.
Well, like you said, the roads, we knew, didn't think they weren't getting any better. And people always, you always have this conversation once a year about why did you do this or why did you do that. Like you said, we always try to err on the side of the safety of students. And I always tell people, your crystal ball is just as good as mine is. So,
yeah.
We do the
and
best
the weatherman is the only one that can be wrong all the time and still do okay.
Rick, anything for the board? Any comments? Stacy? Tom?
Yeah.
Steve? Any public comment or anyone from the public that would like to speak? You can tell it's a cold, snowy night because they're employees. Then if they're,
I say there's no public here.
I just, you mentioned the concert that we had the other night, and I appreciate the recognition on that. But I got to tell you, Mrs. Weaver, she just does a fantastic job, and you know she works so well with those kids. And if you saw it, you could see the hard work pays off, and the kids did a great job. It was a great concert, and all the credit really goes to her. So we're real lucky to have her working with those kids. It makes a huge difference for them, and it showed that night. So
it was a sellout performance. They were standing room only, so I expect we'll get something from the auditorium to make it bigger now. With that, is there any other business? With that, if there's no other business, we'll consider the meeting adjourned.